Have you ever driven by a terrible car accident? It can be sort of shocking. Like, wow, that could actually happen to me. And I find myself driving a little bit slower for the next little while, suddenly aware of the consequences that driving can have. But being a chemistry nerd, my mind also wanders to the airbags. That's right, the airbags. I mean, maybe you've never thought about this because you're not a weird chemistry nerd such as myself, but what has to happen is the airbags are inside the steering wheel. And then within a fraction of a second, when you hit a car, they have to suddenly deploy and fill with air so that they cushion the hard objects around you in the car. How do they do that? I'm going to tell you how. They use a couple chemistry tricks. First of all, they use a chemical reaction that runs really fast. It's an explosion, actually. So they literally use an explosion to fill the airbags. The second trick they use is that they make sure this explosion produces a gas because they want the airbag to be full of gas. Thirdly, they carefully calculate how much gas there should be in the airbag so that it's just full enough. If it's not full enough, it doesn't cushion you. And if it's too full, then the bag could be too firm or even burst. So you can see that chemistry is really necessary to understand these airbags. We're going to actually take a close look at this process and simulate an airbag by filling a Ziploc bag with just the right amount of gas. And I will tell you how to do it. Let's take a look. Let's begin by reviewing our lesson objectives. First, we'll introduce the required materials. Then we'll review the lab procedure. And lastly, we'll walk through the calculations for the lab. These calculations can be a little tricky, so pay close attention here. I'll give you all the info you need. Let's start with those required materials. We're going to take baking soda, and we're going to carefully weigh out a given amount of baking soda and combine that with vinegar. To measure the vinegar, we'll use a cup measure. And these things will be combined in a 1 gallon zipper storage bag or a 1 quart zipper storage bag. So here are all the required materials that you need. If you want, feel free to pause the video, go collect all of those, and then come back and finish the lesson. All right, well, what will we do with all of these materials? That's our lab procedure. First, we'll calculate the quantity of baking soda needed. This is what we're going to go over in full detail in just a second. And basically, we'll work together the one for the gallon Ziploc bag, and then you'll have the responsibility of doing it for the quart zipper bag. Okay. Step two, we'll measure the baking soda and add it to the zipper bag. Now, we want to be able to carefully add the vinegar to it without starting the reaction before we zip it shut. So step three is twist the bag to separate baking soda to one side. Here's a picture of what that looks like. Basically, our baking soda is tucked away into one part of the Ziploc bag. So that way I can add the vinegar to the other side and they won't start reacting and I'll have time to zip it shut. Then we'll add 1 cup of vinegar. That's for the gallon bag. For the quart bag, we'll actually add less. Then we'll place the zipper bag in a sink and slowly shake it until full. It's getting full because of the chemical reaction. You want to do it in the sink because it can make a mess if you got your math wrong. All right, well, let's practice that math. Calculating the required mass of baking soda. Here's our chemical reaction. Baking soda is going to react with vinegar and make a bunch of carbon dioxide gas. That's the bubbles that we're capturing in our Ziploc bag. How will we do the calculation to figure out how much baking soda to add? 3 steps. We'll calculate the moles of carbon dioxide needed to fill our bag. Then we'll calculate the moles of baking soda needed. And then we'll calculate the mass of baking soda needed. So let's start with step one. How many moles of gas fill a 1 gallon zipper bag? Well, to do this math, we need 2 equalities. The first is how much space a mole of gas takes up. Remember that at standard temperature and pressures, which we'll assume we have, 22.4 liters equals 1 mole of gas. The other equality that you'll need is that 3.8 liters is equal to 1 gallon. So we'll start with 1 gallon because we have a 1 gallon zipper bag, and we'll convert that to liters. That will look like 3.8 liters over 1 gallon. Then we'll convert to moles by using our 22.4 liters on the bottom and our 1 mole up top. So notice that the gallons are canceling out and the liters are canceling out and we're left with moles. When we punch this in our calculator, we'll get 0.17 moles of carbon dioxide. Remember, this is the carbon dioxide and not yet the baking soda. So that's step two, calculate the moles of baking soda needed. The trick here is to use our chemical reaction. Notice that one baking soda combines with one molecule of vinegar to make one molecule of CO2. So this is a really boring calculation, but it can be pretty tricky. Remember that we know we want 0.17 moles of CO2. So how many moles of baking soda do we want? Well, because of that 1-to-1 ratio, we can fill in 1 mole of baking soda over 1 mole of CO2, because basically every single mole of CO2 we get out came from 1 mole of baking soda. So that leads to the very boring result of exactly the same number of moles. So remember, for your next calculation that you do, however many moles of CO2 you need, that's the moles of baking soda you also need. Lastly, let's calculate the mass of baking soda needed, because remember, our scale doesn't measure moles, it measures grams. How do we do that? Well, we start with our moles, and we have to use molar mass. So this is the molar mass of baking soda, 84 grams over 1 mole. That's the same molar mass you'll do when you practice with your 1 quart problem. That gives us 14 grams of baking soda when we've rounded to 2 sig figs. So our lab procedure for our gallon bag now looks like this. Calculate the quantity of baking soda needed. Measure 14 grams, which we got from our math, of baking soda and add it to the zipper bag. Twist the bag to separate baking soda to one side. Add a cup of vinegar. Place the zipper bag in the sink and slowly shake until full. So then we'll allow it to mix and shake it up until that gas fills the gallon bag. Here's your lab procedure for the quart bag. This is where the calculations are on you, but we've seen them outlined very carefully. So now you should be able to copy that same math to figure out how much baking soda you need to fill a quart bag. Let's review what we've learned. We introduced the required materials. Then we reviewed the lab procedure, where basically we saw that we were going to combine vinegar and baking soda in a Ziploc bag, either a gallon size or a quart size, and we were going to carefully calculate the mass of baking soda needed so that that bag perfectly inflates. Because that math is a little tricky, we also walked through the calculations for the lab. Good luck getting this lab done.